Today, in the third video of our chicken genetics series, we are going to be talking about how sex-linked genes work. But before we get into it, we need to talk about chromosomes again. Remember how I said chickens have 39 pairs of chromosomes? Well, one of those pairs are their sex chromosomes. We humans have X and Y sex chromosomes, females having two X chromosomes, and males having an X and a Y chromosome. This means that the father's genes determine the gender of a child, because the mother can only give X chromosomes. Well, chickens are just like that, except it's reversed. We refer to the chicken sex chromosomes as Z and W. In chickens, hens have one Z chromosome and one W chromosome, and males have two Z chromosomes. Due to this, the hen sex genes determine the gender of the offspring, not the rooster's. For example, since the rooster can only give Z chromosomes, if the hen gives her Z chromosome, the chick will be male. However, if the hen gives her W chromosome, the chick will be female. Because the Z chromosomes are longer than the W chromosomes, they have more genes on them. For example, the gene for barring is attached to the Z chromosome, as well as the genes for silver, gold, chocolate, and more. Now that we know why sex-linked genes work, let's look at them in action. The first example we will be looking at are silver and gold genetics. The silver and gold genes are attached to the Z chromosome. If you'll remember, since hens only have one Z chromosome, hens can only have one copy of silver or one copy of gold. Because of this, we call them hemizygous for either silver or gold, since they can't be homozygous. Being homozygous for a certain trait means that both genes for that trait or color are the same, but they can't be homozygous for something they can only have one gene for. Since they only have one Z chromosome, hens can either be pure silver or pure gold. They can't be silver split to gold because they can only have one silver or one gold gene, never both. Since roosters have two Z chromosomes, they can be silver split to gold. They could have two silver genes or two gold genes or one silver and one gold gene. Silver is incompletely dominant over gold, and when the two colors combine, they form an intermediate between the two, which makes a yellowish straw-like color. Let's look at some examples to see the sex-linked genes in action. For simplicity's sake, we are going to be using a Punnett square just to make things a little easier. Here we have a homozygous gold rooster over a hemizygous silver hen, and this will produce sex-linked chicks. The silver hen can only ever give her silver gene to her son, never to her daughters. This is because the hen has to give her W chromosome to her daughters for them to be female, and there are no silver or gold genes attached to the W chromosome. Since the rooster is homozygous for gold, he gives one gold gene to all of his sons, making them silver split to gold, as well as a gold gene to all of his daughters. Since this rooster is pure gold and is the only one giving a Z chromosome to the daughters, all of the daughters from this pairing will be pure gold. So, the sons from this pairing will be silver split to gold, and the daughters will be pure gold. Now, let's look at this same pairing, but reversed. This time, the hen is hemizygous for gold, and the rooster is homozygous for silver. The hen gives her one gold gene to all of her sons, and the rooster gives one of his silver genes to all of his sons, meaning all of the sons will be silver split to gold, just like the last pairing. However, since the rooster is silver, he will give one of his silver genes to each of his daughters. And since the hen can only give her W chromosome, otherwise they wouldn't be females, all of the daughters will be pure silver. While both of these pairings do create sex-linked chicks, it might be hard to tell the male silver split to gold chicks apart from the female chicks that may be either silver or gold depending on which pairing you use. Depending on which base from the E series the chicks are on, or what other modifiers or pattern genes may be present, you might have to wait until the hackle and saddle feathers on the male start coming in to tell the males from the females, but this isn't always the case. Let's look at another example, but with barring instead. And thankfully, with this pairing, you can tell the males and females apart as day-old chicks. If you cross a solid-colored rooster, like a Rhode Island Red for an example, with a barred hen, like a barred rock, the solid-colored rooster will give his genes for solid coloring to all of his daughters, And the hen will give her W chromosome, which doesn't have any borrowing genes attached to it, to all of her daughters. This means that all of the daughters will be solid colored. The rooster will give one gene for solid coloring to each of his sons, and the hen will give her gene for borrowing to each of her sons. Since borrowing is incomplete dominant, all of the roosters will be barred. There is a difference between roosters with one copy of the barring gene and roosters with two copies of the barring gene. Roosters that are homozygous for barring, meaning they have two copies of the barring gene, are what we call doubled barred, and they are usually lighter in color than the ones that have one copy of the barring gene, which we call single barred. Hens can only ever be single barred because there's no way for them to have two copies of the barring gene. One last thing before we finish is that sex linkage should not be confused with autosexing. The main difference is autosexing breeds breed true, whereas sex linkage does not. For example, if I took a silver split to gold rooster from one of our previous sex link pairings and bred him with a silver hen from another pairing, I would just end up with silver roosters, silver split to gold roosters, silver hens, and gold hens. You can see here the sex linkage has been lost. Now, if I were to take a silver rooster from one of our previous pairings and put him over a gold hen from another previous pairing, then I would be creating another sex-linked pairing. The sex linkage only works though if I put the right roosters with a certain set of genes over the right hens with another certain set of genes, because it is based off of the parents having the right set of genes to create sex-linked chicks. Autosexing breeds, on the other hand, are breeds that breed true to their autosexing trait. For example, German Bayleyvelders are an autosexing breed that will always breed true to their autosexing feature. At hatch, the males and females will have different chick down color. If you took those chicks, once they grew up, and bred them to German Bayleyvelders from another line, their chicks would have the autosexing feature as well because it breeds true from generation to generation, as long as you keep the line pure by only using German Bayleyvelders. Thank you so much for watching, and this concludes the third part of our chicken genetics series.